Palm Coast was sunny, 84 degrees wind, calm. At Ormond Beach, it was mostly sunny. The temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 82. The relative humidity 94%, heat index 101. Southeast wind, at 3 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.82 inches, and rising. New Smyrna Beach was mostly sunny, temperature 86 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 8 miles per hour. Leesburg was sunny, 84 degrees, wind east at 8 miles per hour. Sanford, it was sunny, temperature 84 degrees, dew point 79, humidity 85%, wind east at 7 miles per hour. Pressure 18, sunny, 84 degrees, wind east at 5 miles per hour. In Orlando, mostly sunny, 82, the wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. Titusville was mostly sunny, temperature 88 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. In Melbourne, mostly sunny, 84, wind south at 5 miles per hour. In Stuart, partly sunny, 82. Tampa, partly sunny, 83, wind east at 8 miles per hour. In Jacksonville, partly sunny, 85, wind north at 3 miles per hour. Miami, mostly sunny, 86, wind south at 7 miles per hour. Again in Daytona Beach, the temperature 84 degrees. Under mostly sunny skies. The latest marine reports. St. Augustine Fishing Pier, air temperature 85 degrees, east wind at 6 knots. At the buoy 10 nautical miles east northeast of St. Augustine, water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 11 seconds. At the buoy 20 nautical miles east of Cape Canaveral, air temperature 85 degrees and water temperature is 86. Seas 3 feet with a period of 10 seconds. Scripps buoy 4 miles east of Port Canaveral, water temperature 84, seas 2 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 6 nautical miles northeast of Fort Pierce Inlet, water temperature 85, seas 3 feet with a period of 9 seconds. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-26 Daytona Beach, broadcasting on a frequency of 162.4 MHz and serving the following counties: Putnam, Flagler, Lake, Orange, Seminole, Northern Brevard and Volusia. Also covering the intracoastal and coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia and Brevard County line out to 60 nautical miles. Severe weather watches, warnings and advisories for these counties and the marine area are preceded by alarm tones which activate specially built receivers. During severe weather, the routine broadcast is suspended in order to broadcast severe weather information. Broadcasts will be interrupted for immediate transmission of severe weather information as soon as it is issued. At all other times, station KIH-26 will broadcast weather information in a cycle of selected products relevant to the station's broadcast coverage area. This broadcast will normally include the following products when available: the hazardous weather outlook for East Central Florida, public forecast from the short term out to 5 days, hourly weather conditions and marine reports for selected locations in and around the broadcast area, marine forecasts out to 5 days, the west wall and hazards for the Gulf Stream, tide information and surf temperatures. Daily climate information is broadcast from 5 a.m. until 8 a.m., and again from 5 p.m. until 8 p.m. Civil emergency and public safety information are broadcast as it is received from local, state and other federal agencies. If you have any questions about NOAA Weather Radio broadcasts, or comments regarding our services, our mailing address is National Weather Service, 421 Croton Road, Melbourne, Florida, 32935. Our telephone number is 321-255-0212. And our website address is weather.gov/Melbourne. Marine forecast for the following: coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. Mostly smooth on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and waves higher in and near thunderstorms. Marine forecast for the following waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet, building to 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet in the afternoon. A dominant period 11 seconds. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, south winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Tuesday, south winds 5 to 10 knots, becoming southeast 15 to 20 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 20 to 25 knots, becoming south 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 45 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet, building to 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet after midnight. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. South winds 35 to 40 knots, becoming southwest 30 to 35 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 7 to 9 feet with occasional seas to 11 feet. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 40 knots, diminishing to 20 to 25 knots, after midnight. Seas 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet. Numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming northwest 10 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. Showers likely and a chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 10 knots. seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and seas higher and near thunderstorms. Gulf Stream hazards, seas boiling to up to 6 feet in the offshore waters north of Sebastian Inlet tonight. The approximate location of the west wall of the Gulf Stream based on the real-time ocean forecast system as of Saturday, August 26th. 47 nautical miles east of Ponce Inlet. 30 nautical miles east of Port Canaveral. 22 nautical miles east of Sebastian Inlet. 17 nautical miles east of Fort Pierce Inlet. 12 nautical miles east of St. Lucie Inlet. The latest available surf temperatures as of Sunday. Daytona Beach was 84 degrees, the Port Canaveral buoy was 84 degrees, Fort Pierce was 86 degrees, and Jensen Beach was 85 degrees. Here is the tide information. Daytona Beach shores, Sun Globe Pier. Low tide Monday at 11:58 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:33 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:55 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:50 a.m. Port Canaveral. Low tide Monday at 11:36 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:17 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:36 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:30 a.m. Sebastian Inlet Bridge. Low tide Monday at 12:10 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:38 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:42 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:49 a.m. Fort Pierce Inlet, South Jetty. Low tide Monday at 12:16 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:55 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:48 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 7:06 a.m. Rip current risk statement for the following counties in Florida, coastal Volusia, mainland Northern Brevard and Northern Brevard Barrier Islands. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. What? Dangerous rip currents and rough surf expected. Where? Coastal Volusia, coastal Indian River, coastal St. Lucie, coastal Martin, and coastal Brevard counties. When? Through late tonight. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Rip currents are powerful channels of water flowing quickly away from shore, which occur most often at low spots or breaks in the sandbar and in the vicinity of structures such as jetties and piers. Heed the advice of lifeguards, beach patrol flags and signs. Entering the water is highly discouraged. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Rip current risk statement for the following county, coastal Flagler, Florida. High rip current risk in effect from 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. What? Dangerous rip currents expected. Where? Northeast Florida beaches. When? 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Swim near a lifeguard. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. The center of tropical storm Idalia is located around 125 miles south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued northward motion expected today and Tuesday. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Florida Gulf Coast Tuesday night into Wednesday as a major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and squalls increases Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday, the possibility of strong to damaging wind gusts will also increase. Tropical storm force winds are forecast to extend outward from the storm center, potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas and Okeechobee County, and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of Idalia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts from Idalia will be felt far from the center of the storm. Now is the time to ensure your hurricane supply kit is stocked and your safety plan is in place. As Idalia becomes better organized through this afternoon, additional changes to the current forecast are possible. Eastward shifts in the forecast track would increase the potential for local impacts, so continue to monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida. Next update. The next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida around 12 noon Eastern Daylight Time, or sooner if conditions warrant. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Orange, Osceola, and Seminole. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch remains in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Northern Lake and Southern Lake. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the center of Hurricane Franklin was located near latitude 27.2 north, longitude 70.8 west. Franklin is moving toward the north-northwest near 8 miles per hour. A gradual turn toward the north and north-northeast with a slightly faster forward speed is expected during the next couple of days. Maximum sustained winds have increased to near 115 miles per hour with higher gusts. This makes Franklin a Category 3 hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. Some additional strengthening is forecast today, but gradual weakening is expected to begin by Tuesday afternoon. Hurricane force winds extend outward up to 30 miles from the center, and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 150 miles. The estimated minimum central pressure is 956 millibars, 28.23 inches. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 7 a.m. Central Daylight Time, the center of tropical storm Idalia was located near latitude 20.6 north, longitude 85.2 west. Idalia is moving toward the north near 8 miles per hour. A northward motion is expected through tonight, followed by a faster north-northeast motion on Tuesday and Wednesday. On the forecast track, the center of Idalia is forecast to pass near or over western Cuba tonight, over the extreme southeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Tuesday, and reach the Gulf Coast of Florida on Wednesday. Maximum sustained winds are near 65 miles per hour with higher gusts. Idalia is forecast to become a hurricane later today and a dangerous major hurricane over the northeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Wednesday. Tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 70 miles from the center. The latest minimum central pressure estimated from data from an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is 989 millibars, 29.21 inches. Tropical Weather Outlook. Issued at 7:40 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. For the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea, and the Gulf of Mexico, Active Systems, the National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on Hurricane Franklin, located several hundred miles southwest of Bermuda, and on Tropical Storm Idalia, located over the northwestern Caribbean Sea. Eastern Tropical Atlantic. A tropical wave is forecast to move off the west coast of Africa in the next day or so. Environmental conditions appear marginally favorable for gradual development of this system, and a tropical depression could form later this week while the system moves westward or west-northwestward across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Formation chance through 48 hours, low, near 0%. Formation chance through 7 days, medium, 50%. Serving Daytona Beach and vicinity, this is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-26, the voice of the National Weather Service. This broadcast comes to you from the National Weather Service office in Melbourne, Florida, on a frequency of 162.4 MHz. A required weekly test of the NOAA Weather Radio Public Warning System is conducted each Wednesday between 11 a.m. and noon, and again between 6 and 8 p.m. If severe weather is expected, this test will be postponed until the following day. The current time is 9:34 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This hazardous weather outlook is for East Central Florida. Day 1, today and tonight. Thunderstorm impact, scattered lightning across East Central Florida this afternoon, though the highest storms will move 10 miles per hour. Main threats will be gusty winds to around 40 to 45 miles per hour, frequent lightning strikes, and locally heavy downpours of 1 to 3 inches in a short period of time. This heavy rainfall could lead to minor flooding of low-lying or poor drainage areas, especially in locations are forecast between 102 to 107 degrees this afternoon across the area prior to showers and storms developing. Remember to stay well hydrated if you'll be engaged in any outdoor activity today. Take indoor rest breaks as needed, preferably in an air-conditioned area. Rip current impact. There is a high risk of dangerous rip currents at area beaches today due to incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin. Rough surf is also expected. Entering the water is highly discouraged. Marine thunderstorm gust impact. Stronger storms moving northward around 10 kts over East Central Florida and the adjacent Atlantic waters will be capable of wind gusts to around 35 knots, frequent lightning strikes, and heavy rainfall. Wind and sea impact. Incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin will cause sea swell offshore north of Sebastian Inlet to build 12 to 6 feet by tonight. Small craft will need to exercise caution. Days 2 through 7, Tuesday through Sunday. A high risk of rip currents and rough surf will continue through at least midweek, as long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin moves into the local Atlantic waters. Tropical storm Idalia, located between the Yucatan Peninsula and western tip of Cuba, is expected to strengthen as it lifts northward into the eastern Gulf of Mexico through midweek. The National Hurricane Center forecasts the system to reach hurricane strength before it moves onshore along the northern Gulf Coast of Florida, but there still remains some uncertainty in the system's track and intensity. Conditions are forecast to deteriorate Tuesday afternoon and evening, with increasing coverage of gusty squalls and heavy rainfall into Wednesday. A few tornadoes will be possible, as well. Boating conditions will become hazardous to dangerous, as Idalia makes landfall, then moves off of the northeastern Florida coast and into the western Atlantic Wednesday. Mariners should closely monitor the forecast for any watches or warnings issued. Rough surf will also lead to dangerous beach conditions and erosion. Persons in East Central Florida should continue to closely monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and the National Weather Service Office in Melbourne regarding this system, as any eastward deviations in the track would bring a greater impact to East Central Florida. This is a good reminder for everyone to have a tropical readiness plan and emergency supply kit in place. After Idalia, high coverage of showers and lightning storms looks to persist over East Central Florida through at least the end of the work week. increasing temperatures may also lead to heat concerns. Spotter information statement. Spotter activation will not be needed today and tonight. The forecast for the Daytona Beach NOAA Weather Radio listening area. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. Today, partly sunny. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms through late morning, then a chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour becoming east 10 to 15 miles per hour with gusts up to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 50%. Heat index readings 101 to 106. Tonight, partly cloudy. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms until around midnight. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour becoming south around 5 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 20%. Tuesday, widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Breezy. Highs around 90. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour increasing to 15 to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 90. Numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 15 to 20 miles per hour with gusts up to 30 miles per hour increasing to 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 45 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 70%. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. South winds 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Chance of rain 90%. Wednesday night, partly cloudy with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Breezy. Lows in the upper 70s. Chance of rain 40%. Thursday, showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Chance of rain 80%. The 9 a.m. weather roundup. At Daytona Beach, under mostly sunny skies, the temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 79, relative humidity 85%, wind southeast at 5 miles per hour. The pressure 29.83 inches and rising. At other area locations. Palm Coast was sunny, 84 degrees wind, calm. At Ormond Beach, it was mostly sunny. The temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 82. The relative humidity 94%, heat index 101. Southeast wind, at 3 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.82 inches, and rising. New Smyrna Beach was mostly sunny, temperature 86 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 8 miles per hour. Leesburg, was sunny, 84 degrees, wind east at 8 miles per hour. Sanford, it was sunny, temperature 84 degrees, dew point 79, humidity 85%, wind east at 7 miles per hour. Pressure 29.83 inches and rising. St. Augustine Airport, was partly sunny, temperature 84 degrees, wind east at 5 miles per hour. In Orlando, mostly sunny, 82, the wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. Titusville, was mostly sunny, temperature 88 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. In Melbourne, mostly sunny, 84, wind south at 5 miles per hour. In Stuart, partly sunny, 82. Tampa, partly sunny, 83, wind east at 8 miles per hour. In Jacksonville, partly sunny, 85, wind north at 3 miles per hour. Miami, mostly sunny, 86, wind south at 7 miles per hour. Again in Daytona Beach, the temperature 84 degrees. Under mostly sunny skies. The latest marine reports. St. Augustine Fishing Pier, air temperature 85 degrees, east wind at 6 knots. At the buoy 10 nautical miles east northeast of St. Augustine, water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 11 seconds. At the buoy 20 nautical miles east of Cape Canaveral, air temperature 85 degrees and water temperature is 86. sees 3 feet with a period of 10 seconds. Scripps buoy 4 miles east of Port Canaveral, water temperature 84, sees 2 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 6 nautical miles northeast of Fort Pierce Inlet, water temperature 85, sees 3 feet with a period of 9 seconds. Marine forecast, for the following, coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. Mostly smooth on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and waves higher in and near thunderstorms. Marine forecast, for the following, waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet, building to 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet in the afternoon. A dominant period 11 seconds. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, south winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Tuesday, south winds 5 to 10 knots, becoming southeast 15 to 20 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 20 to 25 knots, becoming south 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 45 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet, building to 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet after midnight. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. South winds 35 to 40 knots, becoming southwest 30 to 35 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 7 to 9 feet with occasional seas to 11 feet. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 40 knots, diminishing to 20 to 25 knots after midnight. Seas 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet. Numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming northwest 10 knots in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. Showers likely and a chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 10 knots. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and seas higher and near thunderstorms. Gulf Stream hazards, seas boiling to up to 6 feet in the offshore waters north of Sebastian Inlet tonight. The approximate location of the west wall of the Gulf Stream based on the real-time ocean forecast system as of Saturday, August 26. 47 nautical miles east of Ponce Inlet. 30 nautical miles east of Port Canaveral. 22 nautical miles east of Sebastian Inlet. 17 nautical miles east of Fort Pierce Inlet. 12 nautical miles east of St. Lucie Inlet. The latest available surf temperatures as of Sunday. Daytona Beach was 84 degrees, the Port Canaveral buoy was 84 degrees, Fort Pierce was 86 degrees, and Jensen Beach was 85 degrees. Here is the tide information. Daytona Beach shores, Sun Globe Pier. Low tide Monday at 11:58 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:33 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:55 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:50 a.m. Port Canaveral. Low tide Monday at 11:36 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:17 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:36 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:30 a.m. Sebastian Inlet Bridge. Low tide Monday at 12:10 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:38 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:42 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:49 a.m. Fort Pierce Inlet, South Jetty. Low tide Monday at 12:16 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:55 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:48 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 7:06 a.m. Rip current risk statement for the following counties in Florida, coastal Volusia, mainland Northern Brevard and Northern Brevard Barrier Islands. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. What? Dangerous rip currents and rough surf expected. Where? Coastal Volusia, coastal Indian River, coastal St. Lucie, coastal Martin, and coastal Brevard counties. When? Through late tonight. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Rip currents are powerful channels of water flowing quickly away from shore, which occur most often at low spots or breaks in the sandbar and in the vicinity of structures such as jetties and piers. Heed the advice of lifeguards, beach patrol flags and signs. Entering the water is highly discouraged. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Rip current risk statement for the following county, coastal Flagler, Florida. High rip current risk in effect from 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. What? Dangerous rip currents expected. Where? Northeast Florida beaches. When? 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Swim near a lifeguard. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. The center of tropical storm Idalia is located around 125 miles south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued northward motion expected today and Tuesday. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Florida Gulf Coast Tuesday night into Wednesday as a major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. Showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and squalls increases Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday, the possibility of strong to damaging wind gusts will also increase. Tropical storm force winds are forecast to extend outward from the storm center, potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas in Okeechobee County and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of Idalia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts from Idalia will be felt far from the center of the storm. Now is the time to ensure your hurricane supply kit is stocked and your safety plan is in place. As Idalia becomes better organized through this afternoon, additional changes to the current forecast are possible. Eastward shifts in the forecast track would increase the potential for local impacts, so continue to monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida. Next update. The next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida around 12 noon Eastern Daylight Time, or sooner if conditions warrant. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Orange, Osceola, and Seminole. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch remains in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Northern Lake and Southern Lake. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the center of Hurricane Franklin was located near latitude 27.2 north, longitude 70.8 west. Franklin is moving toward the north-northwest near 8 miles per hour. A gradual turn toward the north and north-northeast with a slightly faster forward speed is expected during the next couple of days. Maximum sustained winds have increased to near 115 miles per hour with higher gusts. This makes Franklin a Category 3 hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. Some additional strengthening is forecast today, but gradual weakening is expected to begin by Tuesday afternoon. Hurricane force winds extend outward up to 30 miles from the center and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 150 miles. The estimated minimum central pressure is 956 millibars, 28.23 inches. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 7 a.m. Central Daylight Time, the center of tropical storm Idalia was located near latitude 20.6 north, longitude 85.2 west. Idalia is moving toward the north near 8 miles per hour. A northward motion is expected through tonight, followed by a faster north-northeast motion on Tuesday and Wednesday. On the forecast track, the center of Idalia is forecast to pass near or over western Cuba tonight, over the extreme southeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Tuesday, and reach the Gulf Coast of Florida on Wednesday. Maximum sustained winds are near 65 miles per hour with higher gusts. Idalia is forecast to become a hurricane later today and a dangerous major hurricane over the northeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Wednesday. Tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 70 miles from the center. The latest minimum central pressure estimated from data from an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is 989 millibars, 29.21 inches. Tropical weather outlook. Issued at 7:40 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. For the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea and the Gulf of Mexico, active systems, the National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on Hurricane Franklin, located several hundred miles southwest of Bermuda, and on Tropical Storm Idalia, located over the northwestern Caribbean Sea. Eastern Tropical Atlantic. A tropical wave is forecast to move off the west coast of Africa in the next day or so. Environmental conditions appear marginally favorable for gradual development of this system, and a tropical depression could form later this week while the system moves westward or west-northwestward across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Formation chance through 48 hours, low, near 0%. Formation chance through 7 days, medium, 50%. Serving Daytona Beach and vicinity, this is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-26, the voice of the National Weather Service. This broadcast comes to you from the National Weather Service office in Melbourne, Florida, on a frequency of 162.4 MHz. A required weekly test of the NOAA Weather Radio Public Warning System is conducted each Wednesday between 11 a.m. and noon, and again between 6 and 8 p.m. If severe weather is expected, this test will be postponed until the following day. The current time is 9:59 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This hazardous weather outlook is for East Central Florida. Day 1, today and tonight. Thunderstorm impact, scattered lightning storms are forecast across East Central Florida this afternoon, though the highest chances will be generally inland and along the Treasure Coast. Storms will move northward at around 10 miles per hour. Main threats will be gusty winds to around 40 to 45 miles per hour, frequent lightning strikes, and locally heavy downpours of 1 to 3 inches in a short period of time. This heavy rainfall could lead to minor flooding of low-lying or drainage areas, especially in locations that see any training showers or storms. Excessive heat impact. Afternoon heat indices are forecast to reach between 102 to 107 degrees this afternoon across the area prior to showers and storms developing. Remember to stay well hydrated if you'll be engaged in any outdoor activity today. Take indoor rest breaks as needed, preferably in an air-conditioned area. Rip current impact. There is a high risk of dangerous rip currents at area beaches today due to incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin. Rough surf is also expected. Entering the water is highly discouraged. Marine thunderstorm gust impact. Stronger storms moving northward around 10 kts over East Central Florida and the adjacent Atlantic waters will be capable of wind gusts to around 35 knots, frequent lightning strikes, and heavy rainfall. Wind and sea impact. Incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin will cause sea swell offshore north of Sebastian Inlet to build 12 to 6 feet by tonight. Small craft will need to exercise caution. Days 2 through 7, Tuesday through Sunday. A high risk of rip currents and rough surf will continue through at least midweek, as long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin moves into the local Atlantic waters. Tropical storm Idalia, located between the Yucatan Peninsula and western tip of Cuba, is expected to strengthen as it lifts northward into the eastern Gulf of Mexico through midweek. The National Hurricane Center forecasts the system to reach hurricane strength before it moves onshore along the northern Gulf Coast of Florida, but there still remains some uncertainty in the system's track and intensity. Conditions are forecast to deteriorate Tuesday afternoon and evening, with increasing coverage of gusty squalls and heavy rainfall into Wednesday. A few tornadoes will be possible, as well. Boating conditions will become hazardous to dangerous, as Idalia makes landfall, then moves off of the northeastern Florida coast and into the western Atlantic Wednesday. Mariners should closely monitor the forecast for any watches or warnings issued. Rough surf will also lead to dangerous beach conditions and erosion. Persons in east central Florida should continue to closely monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and the National Weather Service Office in Melbourne regarding this system, as any eastward deviations in the track would bring a greater impact to east central Florida. This is a good reminder for everyone to have a tropical readiness plan and emergency supply kit in place. After Idalia, high coverage of showers and lightning storms looks to persist over east central Florida through at least the end of the work week. Increasing temperatures may also lead to heat concerns. Spotter information statement, spotter activation will not be needed today and tonight. The forecast for the Daytona Beach NOAA weather radio listening area. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. Today, partly sunny. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms through late morning, then a chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour becoming east 10 to 15 miles per hour with gusts up to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 50%. Heat index readings 101 to 106. Tonight, partly cloudy. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms until around midnight. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour becoming south around 5 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 20%. Tuesday, widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Breezy. Highs around 90. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour increasing to 15 to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 90%. Heat index readings 104 to 109. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Mostly cloudy with numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 15 to 20 miles per hour with gusts up to 30 miles per hour increasing to 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 45 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of tropical storm conditions possible. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. South winds 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Chance of rain 90%. Wednesday night, partly cloudy with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Breezy. Lows in the upper 70s. Chance of rain 40%. Thursday, showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Chance of rain 80%. The 9 a.m. weather roundup. At Daytona Beach, under mostly sunny skies, the temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 79, relative humidity 85%, wind southeast at 5 miles per hour. The pressure 29.83 inches and rising. At other area locations. Palm Coast was sunny, 84 degrees wind, calm. At Ormond Beach, it was mostly sunny. The temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 82. The relative humidity 94%, heat index 101. Southeast wind at 3 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.82 inches and rising. New Smyrna Beach was mostly sunny, temperature 86 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 8 miles per hour. Leesburg was sunny, 84 degrees, wind east at 8 miles per hour. Sanford, it was sunny, temperature 84 degrees, dew point 79, humidity 85%, wind east at 7 miles per hour. Pressure 29.83 inches and rising. St. Augustine Airport was partly sunny, temperature 84 degrees, wind east at 5 miles per hour. In Orlando, mostly sunny, 82, the wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. Titusville was mostly sunny, temperature 88 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. In Melbourne, mostly sunny, 84, wind south at 5 miles per hour. In Stuart, partly sunny, 82. Tampa, partly sunny, 80. Jacksonville, partly sunny. 85 at 3 miles per hour. Miami, mostly sunny, 86, wind south at 7 miles per hour. Again in Daytona Beach, the temperature 84 degrees. Under mostly sunny skies. The latest marine reports. St. Augustine Fishing Pier, air temperature 85 degrees, east wind at 6 knots. At the buoy 10 nautical miles east northeast of St. Augustine, water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 11 seconds. At the buoy 20 nautical miles east of Cape Canaveral, air temperature 85 degrees and water temperature is 86. Seas 3 feet with a period of 10 seconds. Scripps buoy 4 miles east of Port Canaveral, water temperature 84, seas 2 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 6 nautical miles northeast of Fort Pierce Inlet, water temperature 85, seas 3 feet with a period of 9 seconds. Marine Beach to the Vaux County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. Mostly smooth on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and waves higher in and near thunderstorms. Marine forecast for the following waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet, building to 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet in the afternoon. A dominant period 11 seconds. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, south winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Tuesday, south winds 5 to 10 knots, becoming southeast 15 to 20 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 20 to 25 knots, becoming south 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 45 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet, building to 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet after midnight. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. South winds 35 to 40 knots, becoming southwest 30 to 35 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 7 to 9 feet with occasional seas to 11 feet. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 40 knots, diminishing to 20 to 25 knots, after midnight. Seas 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet. Numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming northwest 10 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. Showers likely and a chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 10 knots. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and seas higher and near thunderstorms. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH 26 Daytona Beach, broadcasting on a frequency of 162.4 MHz and serving the following counties: Putnam, Flagler, Lake, Orange, Seminole, Northern Brevard, and Volusia. Also covering the intracoastal and coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia and Brevard County line out to 60 nautical miles. Severe weather watches, warnings and advisories for these counties and the marine area are preceded by alarm tones which activate specially built receivers. During severe weather, the routine broadcast is suspended in order to broadcast severe weather information. Broadcasts will be interrupted for immediate transmission of severe weather information as soon as it is issued. At all other times, station KIH 26 will broadcast weather information in a cycle of selected products relevant to the station's broadcast coverage area. This broadcast will normally include the following products when available: the hazardous weather outlook for East Central Florida, public forecast from the short term out to 5 days, hourly weather conditions and marine reports for selected locations in and around the broadcast area, marine forecasts out to 5 days, the west wall and hazards for the Gulf Stream, tide information and surf temperatures. Daily climate information is broadcast from 5 a.m. until 8 a.m., and again from 5 p.m. until 8 p.m. Civil emergency and public safety information are broadcast as it is received from local, state and other federal agencies. If you have any questions about NOAA Weather Radio broadcasts, or comments regarding our services, our mailing address is National Weather Service, 421 Croton Road, Melbourne, Florida, 32935. Our telephone number is 321-255-0212. And our website address is weather.gov/Melbourne. Gulf Stream hazards. Seas boiling to up to 6 feet in the offshore waters north of Sebastian Inlet tonight. The approximate location of the west wall of the Gulf Stream based on the real-time ocean forecast system as of Saturday, August 26th. 47 nautical miles east of Ponce Inlet. 30 nautical miles east of Port Canaveral. 22 nautical miles east of Sebastian Inlet. 17 nautical miles east of Fort Pierce Inlet. 12 nautical miles east of St. Lucie Inlet. The latest available surf temperatures as of Sunday. Daytona Beach was 84 degrees, the Port Canaveral buoy was 84 degrees, Fort Pierce was 86 degrees, and Jensen Beach was 85 degrees. Here is the tide information. Daytona Beach shores, Sun Globe Pier. Low tide Monday at 11:58 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:33 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:55 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:50 a.m. Port Canaveral. Low tide Monday at 11:36 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:17 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:36 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:30 a.m. Sebastian Inlet Bridge. Low tide Monday at 12:10 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:38 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:42 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:49 a.m. Fort Pierce Inlet, South Jetty. Low tide Monday at 12:16 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:55 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:48 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 7:06 a.m. Rip currents in Florida, coastal Volusia, mainland northern Brevard and northern Brevard through late tonight. What? Dangerous rip currents and rough surf expected. Where? Coastal Volusia, coastal Indian River, coastal St. Lucie, coastal Martin, and coastal Brevard counties. When? Through late tonight. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Rip currents are powerful channels of water flowing quickly away from shore, which occur most often at low spots or breaks in the sandbar and in the vicinity of structures such as jetties and piers. Heed the advice of lifeguards, beach patrol flags and signs. Entering the water is highly discouraged. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Rip current risk statement for the following daylight time. What? Dangerous rip current expected. Where? Northeast Florida beaches. When? 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. Impacts. Rip currents can away from water. Swim. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Tropical Storm Idalia forecast. Just as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today, new information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. The center of Tropical Storm Idalia is located around 125 miles south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued northward motion expected today and Tuesday. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Florida major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. Showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and squalls increases Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday, the possibility of strong to damaging wind gusts will also increase. Tropical storm force winds are forecast to extend outward from the storm center, potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas and Okeechobee County, and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of a dahlia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts from Idalia will be felt far from the center of the storm. Now is the time to ensure your hurricane supply kit is stocked and your safety plan is in place. As Idalia becomes better organized through this afternoon, additional changes to the current forecast are possible. Eastward shifts in the forecast track would increase the potential for local impacts, so continue to monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida. Next update. The next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida around 12 noon Eastern Daylight Time, or sooner if conditions warrant. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Orange, Osceola, and Seminole. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch remains in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Northern Lake and Southern Lake. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the center of Hurricane Franklin was located near latitude 27.2 north, longitude 70.8 west. Franklin is moving toward the north-northwest near 8 miles per hour. A gradual turn toward the north and north-northeast with a slightly faster forward speed is expected during the next couple of days. Maximum sustained winds have increased to near 115 miles per hour with higher gusts. This makes Franklin a Category 3 hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. Some additional strengthening is forecast today, but gradual weakening is expected to begin by Tuesday afternoon. Hurricane force winds extend outward up to 30 miles from the center and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 150 miles. The estimated minimum central pressure is 956 millibars, 28.23 inches. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 7 a.m. Central Daylight Time, the center of tropical storm Idalia was located near latitude 20.6 north, longitude 85.2 west. Idalia is moving toward the north near 8 miles per hour. A northward motion is expected through tonight, followed by a faster north-northeast motion on Tuesday and Wednesday. On the forecast track, the center of Idalia is forecast to pass near or over western Cuba tonight, over the extreme southeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Tuesday, and reach the Gulf Coast of Florida on Wednesday. Maximum sustained winds are near 65 miles per hour with higher gusts. Idalia is forecast to become a hurricane later today and a dangerous major hurricane over the northeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Wednesday. Tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 70 miles from the center. The latest minimum central pressure estimated from data from an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is 989 millibars, 29.21 inches. Tropical weather outlook. Issued at 7:40 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. For the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea and the Gulf of Mexico, active systems, the National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on Hurricane Franklin, located several hundred miles southwest of Bermuda, and on Tropical Storm Idalia, located over the northwestern Caribbean Sea. Eastern Tropical Atlantic, a tropical wave is forecast to move off the west coast of Africa in the next day or so. Environmental conditions appear marginally favorable for gradual development of this system, and a tropical depression could form later this week while the system moves westward or west-northwestward across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Formation chance through 48 hours, low, near 0%. Formation chance through 7 days, medium, 50%. Serving Daytona Beach and vicinity, this is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-26, the voice of the National Weather Service. This broadcast comes to you from the National Weather Service office in Melbourne, Florida, on a frequency of 162.4 MHz. A required weekly test of the NOAA Weather Radio Public Warning System is conducted each Wednesday, between 11 a.m. and noon, and again between 6 and 8 p.m. If severe weather is expected, this test will be postponed until the following day. The current time is 10:27 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This hazardous weather outlook is for East Central Florida. Day 1, today and tonight. Thunderstorm impact, scattered lightning storms are forecast across East Central Florida this afternoon, though the highest chances will be generally inland and along the Treasure Coast. Storms will move northward at around 10 miles per hour. Main threats will be gusty winds to around 40 to 45 miles per hour, frequent lightning strikes, and locally heavy downpours of 1 to 3 inches in a short period of time. This heavy rainfall could lead to minor flooding of low-lying and poor drainage areas, especially in locations that see any training showers or storms. Excessive heat impact. Afternoon heat indices are forecast to reach between 102 to 107 degrees this afternoon across the area prior to showers and storms developing. Remember to stay well hydrated if you'll be engaged in any outdoor activity today. Take indoor rest breaks as needed, preferably in an air-conditioned area. Rip current impact. There is a high risk of dangerous rip currents at area beaches today due to incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin. Rough surf is also expected. Entering the water is highly discouraged. Marine thunderstorm gust impact. Stronger storms moving northward around 10 kts over East Central Florida and the adjacent Atlantic waters will be capable of wind gusts to around 35 knots, frequent lightning strikes, and heavy rainfall. Wind and sea impact. Incoming long period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin will cause sea swell offshore north of Sebastian Inlet to build 12 to 6 feet by tonight. Small craft will need to exercise caution. Days 2 through 7, Tuesday through Sunday. A high risk of rip currents and rough surf will continue through at least midweek, as long period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin moves into the local Atlantic waters. Tropical storm Idalia, located between the Yucatan Peninsula and western tip of Cuba, is expected to strengthen as it lifts northward into the eastern Gulf of Mexico through midweek. The National Hurricane Center forecasts the system to reach hurricane strength before it moves onshore along the northern Gulf Coast of Florida, but there still remains some uncertainty in the system's track and intensity. Conditions are forecast to deteriorate Tuesday afternoon and evening, with increasing coverage of gusty squalls and heavy rainfall into Wednesday. A few tornadoes will be possible, as well. Boating conditions will become hazardous to dangerous, as Idalia makes landfall, then moves off of the northeastern Florida coast and into the western Atlantic Wednesday. Mariners should closely monitor the forecast for any watches or warnings issued. Rough surf will also lead to dangerous beach conditions and erosion. Persons in East Central Florida should continue to closely monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and the National Weather Service Office in Melbourne regarding this system, as any eastward deviations in the track would bring a greater impact to East Central Florida. This is a good reminder for everyone to have a tropical readiness plan and emergency supply kit in place. After Idalia, high coverage of showers and lightning storms looks to persist over East Central Florida through at least the end of the work week. Increasing temperatures may also lead to heat concerns. Spotter information statement. Spotter activation will not be needed today and tonight. The forecast for the Daytona Beach NOAA Weather Radio listening area. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. Today, partly sunny. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms through late morning, then a chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour becoming east 10 to 15 miles per hour with gusts up to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 50%. Heat index readings 101 to 106. Tonight, partly cloudy. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms until around midnight. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour becoming south around 5 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 20%. Tuesday, widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Breezy. Highs around 90. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour increasing to 15 to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 90%. heat index readings 104 to 109. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Mostly cloudy with numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 15 to 20 miles per hour with gusts up to 30 miles per hour, increasing to 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 45 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 70%. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. South winds 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Chance of rain 90%. Wednesday night, partly cloudy with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Breezy. Lows in the upper 70s. Chance of rain 40%. Thursday, showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Chance of rain 80%. The 10 a.m. weather roundup. At Daytona Beach, under partly sunny skies, the temperature was 86 degrees, dew point 79, relative humidity 79%, with heat index of 99, wind south at 5 miles per hour. The pressure 29.85 inches and rising. At other area locations, Palm Coast was mostly sunny, 88 degrees wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. At Ormond Beach, it was partly sunny. The temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 82. The relative humidity 94%, heat index 101. Southeast wind at 7 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.84 inches and rising. New Smyrna Beach was mostly sunny, temperature 88 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. Leesburg was mostly sunny, 85 degrees, wind southeast at 10 miles per hour. Sanford, it was partly sunny, temperature 86 degrees, dew point 77, humidity 74%, and heat index 97, wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. Pressure 29.84 inches and rising. St. Augustine Airport was partly sunny, temperature 87 degrees, the heat index 101, wind east at 9 miles per hour. In Orlando, mostly sunny, 85, the wind south at 9 miles per hour. Titusville was mostly sunny, temperature 90 degrees, the heat index 105, wind south at 10 miles per hour. In Melbourne, mostly sunny, 86, wind south at 7 miles per hour. In Stuart, partly sunny, 82. Tampa, partly sunny, 85, wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. In Jacksonville, partly sunny, 85, wind north at 5 miles per hour. Miami, partly sunny, 87, wind south at 9 miles per hour. Again in Daytona Beach, the temperature 86 degrees, a heat index of 99. Under partly sunny skies. The latest marine reports. St. Augustine Fishing Pier, air temperature 85 degrees, east wind at 6 knots. At the buoy 10 nautical miles east-northeast of St. Augustine, water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 20 nautical miles east of Cape Canaveral, air temperature 83 degrees and water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 9 seconds. Scripps buoy 4 miles east of Port Canaveral, water temperature 84, seas 2 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 6 nautical miles northeast of Fort Pierce Inlet, water temperature 85, seas 2 feet with a period of 11 seconds. Marine forecast for the following coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. Mostly smooth on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and waves higher in and near thunderstorms. Marine forecast for the following waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet, building to 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet in the afternoon. A dominant period 11 seconds. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, south winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Tuesday, south winds 5 to 10 knots, becoming southeast 15 to 20 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 20 to 25 knots, becoming south 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 45 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet, building to 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet after midnight. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. South winds 35 to 40 knots, becoming southwest 30 to 35 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 7 to 9 feet with occasional seas to 11 feet. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 25 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 40 knots, diminishing to 20 to 25 knots, after midnight. Seas 6 to 8 feet with occasional seas to 10 feet. Numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming northwest 10 knots, in the afternoon. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. Showers likely and a chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 10 knots. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and seas higher in and near thunderstorms. Gulf Stream hazards. Seas boiling to up to 6 feet in the offshore waters north of Sebastian Inlet tonight. The approximate location of the west wall of the Gulf Stream based on the real-time ocean forecast system as of Saturday, August 26. 47 nautical miles east of Ponce Inlet. 30 nautical miles east of Port Canaveral. 22 nautical miles east of Sebastian Inlet. 17 nautical miles east of Fort Pierce Inlet. 12 nautical miles east of St. Lucie Inlet. The latest available surf temperatures as of Monday. Daytona Beach was 84 degrees, the Port Canaveral buoy was 84 degrees, Fort Pierce was 84 degrees, and Jensen Beach was 84 degrees. Here is the tide information. Daytona Beach shores, Sun Globe Pier. Low tide Monday at 11:58 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:33 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:55 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:50 a.m. Port Canaveral. Low tide Monday at 11:36 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:17 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:36 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:30 a.m. Sebastian Inlet Bridge. Low tide Monday at 12:10 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:38 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:42 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:49 a.m. Fort Pierce Inlet, South Jetty. Low tide Monday at 12:16 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:55 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:48 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 7:06 a.m. Rip current risk statement for the following counties in Florida: coastal Volusia, mainland Northern Brevard and Northern Brevard Barrier Islands. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. What? Dangerous rip current and rough surf expected. Where? Coastal Volusia, coastal Indian River, coastal St. Lucie, coastal Martin, and coastal Brevard counties. When? Through late tonight. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Rip currents are powerful channels of water flowing quickly away from shore, which occur most often at low spots or breaks in the sandbar and in the vicinity of structures such as jetties and piers. Heed the advice of lifeguards, beach patrol flags and signs. Entering the water is highly discouraged. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Rip current risk statement for the following county: coastal Flagler, Florida. High rip current risk in effect from 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. What? Dangerous rip current expected. Where? Northeast Florida beaches. When? 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Swim near a lifeguard. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. The center of tropical storm Idalia is located around 125 miles south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued north motion. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Gulf Coast Tuesday night into Wednesday as a major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. Showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas and Okeechobee County, and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of Idalia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts from Idalia will be felt far from the center of the storm. Now is the time to ensure your hurricane supply kit is stocked and your safety plan is in place. As Idalia becomes better afternoon, additional changes to the current forecast are possible. Eastward shifts in the forecast track would increase the potential for local impacts, so continue to monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida. Next update. The next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida around 12 noon Eastern Daylight Time, or sooner if conditions warrant. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Orange, Osceola, and Seminole. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch remains in effect for the following counties, in Florida, Northern Lake and Southern Lake. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the center of Hurricane Franklin was located near latitude 27.2 north, longitude 70.8 west. Franklin is moving toward the north-northwest near 8 miles per hour. A gradual turn toward the north and north-northeast with a slightly faster forward speed is expected during the next couple of days. Maximum sustained winds have increased to near 115 miles per hour with higher gusts. This makes Franklin a Category 3 hurricane on the Saffir-Simpson hurricane wind scale. Some additional strengthening is forecast today, but gradual weakening is expected to begin by Tuesday afternoon. Hurricane force winds extend outward up to 30 miles from the center, and tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 150 miles. The estimated minimum central pressure is 956 millibars, 28.23 inches. The latest tropical cyclone advisory, at 7 a.m. Central Daylight Time, the center of tropical storm Idalia was located near latitude 20.6 north, longitude 85.2 west. Idalia is moving toward the north near 8 miles per hour. A northward motion is expected through tonight, followed by a faster north-northeast motion on Tuesday and Wednesday. On the forecast track, the center of Idalia is forecast to pass near or over western Cuba tonight, over the extreme southeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Tuesday, and reach the Gulf Coast of Florida on Wednesday. Maximum sustained winds are near 65 miles per hour with higher gusts. Idalia is forecast to become a hurricane later today and a dangerous major hurricane over the northeastern Gulf of Mexico by early Wednesday. Tropical storm force winds extend outward up to 70 miles from the center. The latest minimum central pressure estimated from data from an Air Force Reserve reconnaissance aircraft is 989 millibars, 29.21 inches. Tropical weather outlook. Issued at 7:40 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. For the North Atlantic, Caribbean Sea and the Gulf of Mexico, active systems, the National Hurricane Center is issuing advisories on Hurricane Franklin, located several hundred miles southwest of Bermuda, and on Tropical Storm Idalia, located over the northwestern Caribbean Sea. Eastern Tropical Atlantic, a tropical wave is forecast to move off the west coast of Africa in the next day or so. Environmental conditions appear marginally favorable for gradual development of this system, and a tropical depression could form later this week while the system moves westward or west-northwestward across the eastern tropical Atlantic. Formation chance through 48 hours, low, near 0%. Formation chance through 7 days, medium, 50%. Serving Daytona Beach and vicinity, this is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-26, the voice of the National Weather Service. This broadcast comes to you from the National Weather Service office in Melbourne, Florida, on a frequency of 162.4 MHz. A required weekly test of the NOAA Weather Radio Public Warning System is conducted each Wednesday between 11 a.m. and noon, and again between 6 and 8 p.m. If severe weather is expected, this test will be postponed until the following day. The current time is 10:53 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. This hazardous weather outlook is for East Central Florida. Day 1, today and tonight. Thunderstorm impact, scattered lightning storms are forecast across East Central Florida this afternoon, though the highest chances will be generally inland and along the Treasure Coast. Storms will move northward at around 10 miles per hour. Main threats will be gusty winds to around 40 to 45 miles per hour, frequent lightning strikes, and locally heavy downpours of 1 to 3 inches in a short period of time. This heavy rainfall could lead to minor flooding of low-lying or drainage areas, especially in locations that see any training showers or storms. Excessive heat impact. Afternoon heat indices are forecast to reach between 102 to 107 degrees this afternoon across the area prior to showers and storms developing. Remember to stay well hydrated if you'll be engaged in any outdoor activity today. Take indoor rest breaks as needed, preferably in an air-conditioned area. Rip current impact. There is a high risk of dangerous rip currents at area beaches today due to incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin. Rough surf is also expected. Entering the water is highly discouraged. Marine thunderstorm gust impact. Stronger storms moving northward around 10 kts over East Central Florida and adjacent Atlantic waters will be capable of wind gusts to around 35 knots, frequent lightning strikes, and heavy rainfall. Wind and sea impact. Incoming long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin will cause sea swell offshore north of Sebastian Inlet to build 12 to 6 feet by tonight. Small craft will need to exercise caution. Days 2 through 7, Tuesday through Sunday. A high risk of rip currents and rough surf will continue through at least midweek, as long-period swell from distant Hurricane Franklin moves into the local Atlantic waters. Tropical storm Idalia, located between the Yucatan Peninsula and western tip of Cuba, is expected to strengthen as it lifts northward into the eastern Gulf of Mexico through midweek. The National Hurricane Center forecasts the system to reach hurricane strength before it moves onshore along the northern Gulf Coast of Florida, but there still remains some uncertainty in the system's track and intensity. Conditions are forecast to deteriorate Tuesday afternoon and evening, with increasing coverage of gusty squalls and heavy rainfall into Wednesday. A few tornadoes will be possible, as well. Boating conditions will become hazardous to dangerous, as Idalia makes landfall, then moves off of the northeastern Florida coast and into the western Atlantic Wednesday. Mariners should closely monitor the forecast for any watches or warnings issued. Rough surf will also lead to dangerous beach conditions and erosion. Persons in East Central Florida should continue to closely monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and the National Weather Service Office in Melbourne regarding this system, as any eastward deviations in the track would bring a greater impact to East Central Florida. This is a good reminder for everyone to have a tropical readiness plan and emergency supply kit in place. After Idalia, high coverage of showers and lightning storms looks to persist over East Central Florida through at least the end of the work week. Increasing temperatures may also lead to heat concerns. Spotter information statement. Spotter activation will not be needed today and tonight. The forecast for the Daytona Beach NOAA Weather Radio listening area. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. Today, partly sunny. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms through late morning, then a chance of afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. southeast winds 5 to 10 miles per hour, becoming east 10 to 15 miles per hour with gusts up to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 50%. Heat index readings 101 to 106. Tonight, partly cloudy. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms until around midnight. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour, becoming south around 5 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 20%. Tuesday, widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Breezy. Highs around 90. Southeast winds 10 to 15 miles per hour, increasing to 15 to 20 miles per hour in the afternoon. Chance of rain 90%. Heat index readings 104 to 109. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Mostly cloudy with numerous showers and scattered thunderstorms. Lows in the upper 70s. Southeast winds 15 to 20 miles per hour with gusts up to 30 miles per hour, increasing to 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 45 miles per hour after midnight. Chance of rain 70%. Wednesday, tropical storm conditions possible. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. South winds 25 to 30 miles per hour with gusts up to 40 miles per hour. Chance of rain 90%. Wednesday night, partly cloudy with scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Breezy. Lows in the upper 70s. Chance of rain 40%. Thursday, showers and thunderstorms. Highs in the upper 80s. Chance of rain 80%. The 10 a.m. weather roundup. At the Daytona Beach, under partly sunny skies, the temperature was 86 degrees, dew point 79, relative humidity 79%, with heat index of 99, wind south at 5 miles per hour. The pressure 29.85 inches and rising. At other area locations, Palm Coast was mostly sunny, 88 degrees wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. At Ormond Beach, it was partly sunny. The temperature was 84 degrees, dew point 82. The relative humidity 94%, heat index 101. Southeast wind at 7 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.84 inches and rising. New Smyrna Beach was mostly sunny, temperature 88 degrees, the heat index 102, wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. Leesburg was mostly sunny, 85 degrees, wind southeast at 10 miles per hour. Sanford, it was partly sunny, temperature 86 degrees, dew point 77, humidity 74%, and heat index 97, wind southeast at 9 miles per hour. Pressure 29.84 inches and rising. St. Augustine Airport was partly sunny, temperature 87 degrees, the heat index 101, wind east at 9 miles per hour. In Orlando, mostly sunny, 85, the wind south at 9 miles per hour. Titusville was mostly sunny, temperature 90 degrees, the heat index 105, wind south at 10 miles per hour. In Melbourne, mostly sunny, 86, wind south at 7 miles per hour. In Stuart, partly sunny, 82. Tampa, partly sunny, 85, wind southeast at 6 miles per hour. In Jacksonville, partly sunny, 85, wind north at 5 miles per hour. Miami, partly sunny, 87, wind south at 9 miles per hour. Again in Daytona Beach, the temperature 86 degrees, a heat index of 99. Under partly sunny skies. The latest marine reports. St. Augustine Fishing Pier, air temperature 85 degrees, east wind at 6 knots. At the buoy 10 nautical miles east-northeast of St. Augustine, water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 20 nautical miles east of Cape Canaveral, air temperature 83 degrees and water temperature is 85. Seas 3 feet with a period of 9 seconds. Scripps buoy 4 miles east of Port Canaveral, water temperature 84, seas 2 feet with a period of 10 seconds. At the buoy 6 nautical miles northeast of Fort Pierce Inlet, water temperature 85, seas 2 feet with a period of 11 seconds. marine forecast for the following coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday, tropical storm watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties in Florida. Waters to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles. Today, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 4 feet with occasional seas to 5 feet. A dominant period 10 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tonight, southeast winds 10 to 15 knots, becoming south 5 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. A slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Tuesday, southeast winds 5 to 10 knots, increasing to 10 to 15 knots in the afternoon. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. A dominant period 12 seconds. A moderate chop on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Tuesday night, tropical storm conditions possible. Southeast winds 15 to 20 knots, becoming south 30 to 35 knots, with gusts up to 50 knots, after midnight. Seas 4 to 6 feet with occasional seas to 7 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday, hurricane conditions possible. Southwest winds 35 to 40 knots, with gusts up to 55 knots. Seas 5 to 7 feet with occasional seas to 9 feet. Extremely rough on the intracoastal waters. Widespread showers and scattered thunderstorms. Wednesday night, southwest winds 20 to 25 knots, diminishing to 15 to 20 knots, after midnight. Seas 3 to 5 feet with occasional seas to 6 feet. Rough on the intracoastal waters. Scattered showers and isolated thunderstorms. Thursday, west winds 10 knots, becoming north in the afternoon. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Thursday night, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots, seas 2 to 3 feet. Mostly smooth on the intracoastal waters. A chance of showers and a slight chance of thunderstorms. Friday, northeast winds 5 to 10 knots. Seas 2 to 3 feet. A light chop on the intracoastal waters. Showers and thunderstorms likely. Winds and waves higher in and near thunderstorms. The latest available surf temp. Tropical storm watch. A tropical storm watch remains in effect for the following counties in Florida: Orange, Osceola, and Seminole. Tropical storm watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties in Florida: Coastal Volusia, Inland Northern Brevard, Inland Southern Brevard, Inland Volusia, Mainland Northern Brevard, Mainland Southern Brevard, Northern Brevard Barrier Islands, and Southern Brevard Barrier Islands. The latest available surf temperatures as of Monday. Daytona Beach was 84 degrees, the Port Canaveral buoy was 84 degrees, Fort Pierce was 84 degrees, and Jensen Beach was 84 degrees. Here is the tide information. Daytona Beach shores, Sun Globe Pier. Low tide Monday at 11:58 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:33 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:55 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:50 a.m. Port Canaveral. Low tide Monday at 11:36 a.m. High tide Monday at 6:17 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:36 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:30 a.m. Sebastian Inlet Bridge. Low tide Monday at 12:10 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:38 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:42 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 6:49 a.m. Fort Pierce Inlet, South Jetty. Low tide Monday at 12:16 p.m. High tide Monday at 6:55 p.m. Low tide Tuesday at 12:48 a.m. High tide Tuesday at 7:06 a.m. Rip current risk statement for the following counties in Florida: Coastal Volusia, Mainland Northern Brevard, and Northern Brevard Barrier Islands. High rip current risk in effect through late tonight. What? Dangerous rip current and rough surf expected. Where? Coastal Volusia, Coastal Indian River, Coastal St. Lucie, Coastal Martin, and Coastal Brevard counties. When? Through late tonight. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Rip currents are powerful channels of water flowing quickly away from shore, which occur most often at low spots or breaks in the sandbar and in the vicinity of structures such as jetties and piers. Heed the advice of lifeguards, beach patrol flags, and signs. Entering the water is highly discouraged. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Rip current risk statement for the following county: Coastal Flagler, Florida. High rip current risk in effect from 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. What? Dangerous rip currents expected. Where? Northeast Florida beaches. When? 7 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time through this evening. Impacts. Rip currents can sweep even the best swimmers away from shore into deeper water. Swim near a lifeguard. If caught in a rip current, relax and float. Don't swim against the current. If able, swim in a direction following the shoreline. If unable to escape, face the shore and call or wave for help. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information. Current watches. Tropical storm watch. For the following: coastal waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles, and waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, extending from 20 nautical miles to 60 nautical miles. Tropical storm watch in effect. What? East winds 35 to 45 knots, with gusts up to 70 knots, and seas 11 to 16 Fort Ware, coastal waters from Altamaha Sound to Fernandina Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles. Coastal waters from Fernandina Beach to St. Augustine, Florida, out 20 nautical miles. Coastal waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles. Waters from Altamaha Sound, Georgia to Fernandina Beach, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Waters from Fernandina Beach to St. Augustine, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles. And waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles. When, through Wednesday night, impacts, very strong winds will cause hazardous seas which could capsize or damage vessels and reduce visibility. Mariners should consider altering plans to avoid possible hazardous conditions. Remain in port, seek safe harbor, alter course, and slash or secure the vessel for severe wind and seas. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. The center of tropical storm Idalia is located around 125 miles south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued northward motion expected today and Tuesday. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Florida Gulf Coast Tuesday night into Wednesday as a major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. Showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and squalls increases Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday, the possibility of strong to damaging wind gusts will also increase. Tropical storm force winds are forecast to extend outward from the storm center, potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas and Okeechobee County, and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of Idalia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts, tropical storm watch. For the following, coastal waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line out to 20 nautical miles, waters from Flagler Beach to the Volusia Brevard County line extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles, coastal waters from the Volusia Brevard County line to Sebastian Inlet out to 20 nautical miles, and waters from the Volusia Brevard County line to Sebastian Inlet extending from 20 to 60 nautical miles. Tropical storm watch in effect. What? East winds 20 to 30 knots, with gusts up to 45 knots, and seas 5 to 9 feet. Where? Flagler Beach to Volusia Brevard County line 0 to 20 nautical miles, Volusia Brevard County line to Sebastian Inlet 0 to 20 nautical miles, Flagler Beach to Volusia Brevard County line 20 to 60 nautical miles, and Volusia Brevard County line to Sebastian Inlet 20 to 60 nautical miles. When? Until further notice. Impacts, very strong winds will cause hazardous seas which could capsize or damage vessels and reduce visibility. mariners should consider altering plans to avoid possible hazardous conditions. Remain in port, seek safe harbor, alter course, and slash or secure the vessel for severe wind and seas. Tropical storm Idalia forecast to strengthen into a hurricane as it moves into the southeastern Gulf of Mexico later today. New information, current watches and warnings. A tropical storm watch is in effect for Northern Lake, Orange, Osceola, Seminole, and Southern Lake. Situation overview. Well, south of the tip of western Cuba early this morning. Idalia is moving north at about 7 miles per hour, with a continued northward motion expected today and Tuesday. The storm is currently forecast to approach the Florida Gulf Coast Tuesday night into Wednesday as a major hurricane. Preparations should be ongoing for at least tropical storm conditions by midweek. A tropical storm watch is now in effect for Lake, Seminole, Orange and Osceola counties, where confidence is highest in tropical storm conditions occurring. Additional watches may be necessary for portions of east central Florida later this morning. Showers, squalls and thunderstorms associated with outer rain bands from Idalia may reach central Florida by late this afternoon, with conditions further deteriorating Tuesday afternoon and evening as Idalia accelerates north-northeastward across the eastern Gulf of Mexico. As coverage of showers and squalls increases Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday, the possibility of strong to damaging wind gusts will also increase. Tropical storm force winds are forecast to extend outward from the storm center, potentially reaching interior portions of east central Florida Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. Based on the current forecast track, Idalia will make its closest pass to east central Florida late Tuesday night and early Wednesday morning, continuing northeastward during the day on Wednesday. While the heaviest rainfall from Idalia is currently forecast to fall along the Gulf Coast and western Florida Peninsula, gusty squalls will be capable of torrential downpours, especially Tuesday and Wednesday over Lake County. 1 to 2 inches of rain from Monday afternoon through Wednesday night is expected for coastal areas in Okeechobee County, and 2 to 4 inches are expected west of I-95 from Brevard and Osceola counties northward, with locally higher amounts possible. Locations in closer proximity to the center of Idalia, such as Lake County in east central Florida, may receive higher rainfall totals. In addition to strong wind gusts, a threat for tornadoes is forecast to develop as the center of Idalia moves into the eastern Gulf of Mexico from Tuesday afternoon into Wednesday. Incoming swell from Hurricane Franklin combined with winds from Idalia will lead to high seas, rough surf, an increase in life-threatening rip currents, and beach erosion Tuesday into Wednesday. Do not let your guard down, especially in locations outside of the current tropical storm watch. Impacts from Idalia will be felt far from the center of the storm. Now is the time to ensure your hurricane supply kit is stocked and your safety plan is in place. As Idalia becomes better organized through this afternoon, additional changes to the current forecast are possible. Eastward shifts in the forecast track would increase the potential for local impacts, so continue to monitor the latest forecasts from the National Hurricane Center and National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida. Next update. The next local statement will be issued by the National Weather Service in Melbourne, Florida around 12 noon Eastern Daylight Time, or sooner if conditions warrant. Tropical Storm Watch. A tropical storm watch is in effect for the following counties: in Florida, Coastal Flagler, Eastern Putnam, Inland Flagler, and Western Putnam. Tropical Storm Watch. For the following: coastal waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles, and waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, extending from 20 nautical miles to 60 nautical miles. Tropical Storm Watch in effect. What? East winds 35 to 45 knots, with gusts up to 70 knots, and seas 11 to 16. Fort Ware, coastal waters from Altamaha Sound to Fernandina Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles, coastal waters from Fernandina Beach to St. Augustine, Florida, out 20 nautical miles, coastal waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, out 20 nautical miles, waters from Altamaha Sound, Georgia to Fernandina Beach, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles, waters from Fernandina Beach to St. Augustine, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles, and waters from St. Augustine to Flagler Beach, Florida, from 20 to 60 nautical miles. when, through Wednesday night. Impacts, very strong winds will cause hazardous seas which could capsize or damage vessels and reduce visibility. Mariners should consider altering plans to avoid possible hazardous conditions. Remain in port, seek safe harbor, alter course, and slash or secure the vessel for severe wind and seas. Tropical storm warning. A tropical storm watch has been upgraded to a tropical storm warning for the following counties in Florida, Northern Lake and Southern Lake. Tropical storm watch.